Hi everyone, welcome to a new Begijnhoeven video. My name is Rob.
My name is Tommy. And Rob told already in the previous video that we have some really big news to share with you guys.
Yes.
So,
we come to show you. Well, the big news is, you already saw it in the title, probably. We are going to put the stud farm on the market. We're going to sell the stud farm. Maybe for you guys it's a surprise. Maybe for you it's not a surprise, because I always told everybody this is a really big project. And the project is now almost finished after 2.5 years. It's been in massive journey, and I'm really, really proud of the result. I mean, yeah, I really think it's a beautiful, beautiful stable. But well, yeah, it's almost finished, and yeah, it's now time we put it on the market. The Begijnhoeven 1.0, as we call it now these days, was always for sale as well. But it was not out there, you know, so it was not really published or something. But Dirk van Ostaaien, the realtor from Equihome, and in Holland and Belgium they call it Imo Fluisteraar, he sold our place quite suddenly. You maybe all know the story. This time we want to do it a little bit different, because it went so well last time and we are really proud of the result. And I don't want to be sneaky against the grooms and everything. I just want to say what we are going to do. So we talked with Dirk, the realtor, and we told him like, okay, we're just gonna put it out there, we're gonna publish the stable, and we're gonna make a really, really great video of the barn, and we're just going to show you, we're proud on the result. And I'm really, really curious who is going to buy this wonderful place. It really deserves someone who will love it as much as we do. But yeah, I'm really curious, exciting times, and I'm going to show the video right now. Thank you. Now, that was a cool video, I think. I hope you liked the video as well as we did. Now, the big question, of course, why on earth do we want to sell a beautiful place like this? Well, we can tell you, we sold Begijnhoeve 1.0 and we told each other like, okay, now we're gonna sell this place, okay, now it's time to find something smaller. Well, that didn't work out really well. The realtor showed us this place and all the opportunities it has, and we saw it as, yeah, a must do in once in a lifetime opportunity. Is such a beautiful place, such a beautiful area, so we just had to develop a place like this.
Yeah, it was a kind of a once in a lifetime opportunity to build in this area, in this nature, such a beautiful stud farm.
So we just couldn't help it. I just I want to develop. Yeah, that's me.
And then the other question.
Now, the other question, what are we going to do now? If we're going to sell this place, and it probably will take quite some time, so we can still enjoy this this stable, of course. But if we're going to sell it, our plan is to...
Go smaller
now. Now I'm going to listen.
Yes, because he never listens to me, as you know.
No, I have my reasons. for me, I want to focus more on riding, because when you have a stud farm like this, you have quite some things on your mind all the time. And for me, it's kind of hard to focus, and we're still in the age to do some sports, to perform in a dressage ring. So we really want to focus on that part.
And
so that will be very important. And I still want to develop new stud farms or stables or whatever as well. But I think we're going to do it separate. So we're going to build something or create something for ourselves or buy something for ourselves. And besides that, we're going to develop nice stables and sell it again, because it's just a thing I can do. I love it, and it's just something what I love to do. So I'm still going to do that.
And then if we have our own place, which not going to be sold, then the horses can stay there. They don't have to move.
And you can focus more on sports, and it's, you have more rest and calmness. And I don't think we are able to move every 2 years. That's quite exhausting. And I must say, the last two and a half years were,
they went by like,
they went really quick. And many things happened anyway. I mean, I can't even remember all the things, but it's you should not have 2 years like that every 2 years, because that's quite exhausting. But okay. Now you know the reason. I hope you guys liked this video. Show the video everywhere, because we want to show the video to the potential clients. If you like the video, leave a thumbs up or a comment, and don't forget to subscribe. See you.
But coming Sunday, we are going on a competition for the first time since a long time, together with Genesis and Heroes. So I'm going to show finally Genesis for the first time in the Grand Prix.
And I'm going to show finally Heroes after all the shizzle. He's finally back, so I'm really happy I can show him now for real.
So we're going to try to make a nice video about that, and maybe we will put it in the video on Thursday.
Maybe.
See you next Thursday. Thank you.
See you.
Bye-bye.